Hello students, today we will be discussing the first chapter of history part 1 for class 12, that is bricks, beards and bones. This video is presented by Gaurav Kumar, Department of Social Science, Bhavlantri Mehta Vidya Bhavan and Guru Devi Shishing Memorial Academy, second share. Under this chapter, we will be discussing about the Harappan civilization. At the end of the lesson, students will be able to know about Harappan civilization. They will be able to understand the sources to reconstruct the history of Harappan civilization. They will be able to explain the subsistence pattern of Harappan civilization, and they will be able to discuss the features of Harappan town planning. Before moving further, we should know that how historians collect information about the past. Historians are basically dependent on the sources of history, which are basically divided into two broad categories. First is primary sources. Primary source is a source of information that was created at the time under study. It serves as an original source of information about the topic. Another category is secondary sources. Secondary source is a document or recording that relates or discusses information originally presented somewhere else. Now have a look on the map of the Harappan civilization. Here you can see that this is the political boundary of India. So we can say that the maximum part of Harappan civilization is located in current day Pakistan. Here you can also see the Indus River, that is the Indus River. This civilization was located near the Indus River, so it is also known as the Indus Valley civilization. Now come to the sources of Harappan civilization, on which basis we reconstruct their past. Archaeological finds, that is known as the artifacts, for example bows, ornaments, seals, which is one of the most distinctive artifact or important artifact of the Harappan civilization. We have tools used by them for the agriculture purpose and to complete their other tasks. We have bones of animals, what kind of animal they were familiar with. This is a seal, Harappan seal. There is a depiction of a bull which indicate that they were familiar with the bull, and chances are there that they use bull for the agriculture purposes. This is a sculpture of a priest king that is related to the political authority that we will discuss in the further in the next video. Now come to the subsistence strategies of the Harappan people. On the basis of findings or the artifacts, we can say that the Harappan people ate plants and animals products, including fish, finds of charred grapes and seeds, wheat, barley, lentil, chickpea, sesame seeds were also found from there, millets found from the Gujarat, rice was rarely found, which indicate that the rice was not the important part of their food habits. Now, on the basis of finding of animal bones, we can divide them into two broad categories, that is domesticated animals and wild animals. Under the domesticated animals, we have the findings of cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo, pig, fish, fowl, and wild animals we have boar, deer and ghadiyal. Here is a contradiction that historians are not sure whether they hunt these wild animals by themselves or they obtain meat from the other communities. So students, the artifacts, we have the grains were found from the Harappan civilization, the different sites. We know that agriculture was there, but it is very difficult to reconstruct actual agriculture practices. As we discussed earlier, that slide, that bull was known to them because we have representation on seals and in the form of the terracotta sculptures. Oxen was also used for plugging. Wells were used for irrigation. Irrigation was an important part. And reservoir was also found in Dholavira, which indicates that they used to reservoir to store water for the irrigation. Now the question arises, were seeds were broadcasted on plugged lands? I mean, land were first plugged and then seed were scattered or broadcasted. Yes, because plug was used. We have terracotta mortals of plug found in Cholistan, that is in Pakistan, and Banavali, Haryana. For this case, we have to discuss a particular site, that is Kalibangan, situated in current day Rajasthan. In Kalibanga, there was evidence of plugged field found, and on this basis, we can say that there was traces of two sets of plug lines intersects each other at the right angles, which indicates that the Harappan people grew two different crops at the same time. We are talking about the agriculture, then a most important feature or the aspect of agriculture is irrigation. Harappan sites were located in semi-arid areas, so probably the agriculture required irrigation. There was traces of canal found at Shortughai, that is in Afghanistan, and at the same time the traces of canal was not found in Sindh and Punjab. So it is possible that the canal in Sindh and Punjab was silted long back, because no traces of canal was found. Or it may be possible that the people of Sindh and Punjab people, they used well for irrigation, and we discussed in previous slide that the water reservoir was found in Dholapira. It may be used to store water for irrigation. Next is urban planning. Perhaps the most unique feature of the Harappan civilization was the development of urban centers. Let us look at one of such centers, that is Mohenjo-daro, more closely. Divided into a structure was divided into two parts, higher town and lower town. Higher town and lower town. Higher town was known as the citadel or the fort. Lower town was known as a lower town. Higher town was small in size, whereas the lower town was larger in size. Higher town, most important aspect, that it was built up on a huge mud brick, you know, platform, a chabutra, bahut bada. In lower town, some of the houses were made up on, you know, built up on this platform, but not all the houses. Higher town was to make it, you know, physically separate from the lower town, it was walled. Lower town was also walled. Now the question arises, that was urban planning or the Mohenjo-daro was a planned settlement or not? Yes, it was a planned settlement. To support our statements, we have some arguments. First, as we discussed in previous slide, that the upper town or the higher town was built up on a huge mud brick, you know, platform. So it is obvious that once the platform was built, then the entire construction should remain up to a fixed area, that is platform. It indicates that the settlement was first planned and then implemented accordingly. Another example of planned settlements come from the bricks, because sun-dried or baked bricks are other sign of the urban planning. Standardized ratio of the bricks, that is height, length and breadth, were in the ratio of 2:4:8 respectively. There was a planned drainage pattern. Streets were laid down in a grid pattern and intersect each other at the right angles. It seems that streets with drains laid down first and then houses were built along them. So on the basis of all these arguments, we can say that the Harappan civilization or the Mohenjo-daro settlement was properly a planned settlement. Now we will discuss both the aspects of the this urban settlement, domestic architecture, that is lower town and higher town, upper town, citadel separately. Lower town, in the lower town where the common people used to live, courtyard was the center of all activities in a house. Rooms were made up or built up at the sides of the courtyard. Privacy was the most important or the most important concern for the Harappan people, as no windows were found at the ground level, so no one can not peep inside the house that what is happening. And when you are moving in the streets, the main entrance does not give direct view of the house. Bathroom were made up and the drains and with the paved bricks was there. Many houses had wells. Around 700 wells were found in the various sites of the Harappan civilization. They could be reached by bypasses. It means that the wells were located in the outmost portion or the outermost room of the house, so that the people moving going through the streets, they can also use it. There are some example of second floor, second story, because some houses have remains of staircase. Now we have citadel. Citadel is a fort or in upper town. It is on the citadel that we find evidence of structures that were probably used for special public purposes. These include the warehouse, a massive structure of which the lower brick portion remain, while the upper portions, probably made up of wood, decayed long back ago. And the another important was the Great Bath. The Great Bath was a large rectangular tank in a courtyard, surrounded by a corridor on all four sides. There were two flights of steps on the north and south leading into the tanks that were the staircase, which was made watertight by setting bricks on edge and using a mortar of gypsum. There were rooms on three sides, in one of which was a large well. Water from the tank flowed into a huge drain. Across a lane to the north lay a smaller building with eight bathrooms, four on each side of a corridor. The uniqueness of this structure, as well as the context in which it was found, had led scholars to suggest that it was meant for some kind of a special ritual bath. Now you can have a look at the Great Bath of the Mohenjo-daro. There, like you can say, these are the staircase going inside to the tank. This is about the lower town. We have grid pattern where you can see that how the houses were built up. These are not the original findings. They were basically made up on the basis of the evidence we have. This is also you can have a view of the streets or the draining patterns. Now there are some questions for you for the assignment. You can easily use these slides to answer these questions. First of all, what was the geographical extent of Harappan civilization? Then differentiate between primary and secondary sources of history. Then name the most distinctive artifact of the Harappan civilization. On the basis of artifacts, how can you trace the agriculture development in Harappan civilization? Discuss how archaeologists reconstruct the past. Explain the subsistence pattern of Harappan civilization. And discuss the main features of Harappan town planning in detail, or you can say that it explains the distinctive feature of Mohenjo-daro. So dear students, this was the end of the slide. Thank you.